Hi, it's me, Dr. Prasad Puthiyilam. It's my class series on ion exchange chromatography. So chromatography, it is a vast field of qualitative and quantitative estimation of substances, in which ion exchange chromatography is one of the method. So we'll see one by one what do you mean by chromatography. Chromatography is a word obtained from Greek. So it's a Greek in which chroma means color and graphein means to write. That means color which gives writing. Okay, so they first used chromatography method for the separation or estimate separation of pigments. Pigments are having color, therefore they gave the name chromatography. Chromatography is one of the physical method to separate or distribute components based on the stationary as well as the mobile phase. The mobile phase which is moving in a definite direction. So we can see this is one of the schematic representation of chromatography. Okay, so this scheme cannot be used for all type of chromatography experiments. Just giving an idea that there is a mobile phase, there is a moving phase which you call as mobile phase, and there is a stationary phase through which the mixtures like a component A, component B are passed through, and based on their size or their capability to pass through that medium, the separation takes place, and we can separate a mixture of AB into two different components, component A and component two, or component B. So when we discuss about ion exchange chromatography, there are so many terms that we use, like analyte. Analyte is a substance which is used to be separated. It is the one which is to be separated during the chromatography. And as a sample, whatever we use the word sample, it is a matter analyzed in chromatography. Eluate or effluent, it is a mobile phase leaving the column. Eluent is the solvent that carries the analyte. And here solvent refers any substance capable of solubilizing another substance. Eluite, E-L-U-I-T-E, is the analyte at eluted solute. And solute refers to the sample components in partition chromatography. The stationary phase is the substance fixed in place for the chromatographic procedure, and the detector is the one which it's an instrument which is used to qualitatively and quantitatively measure the analytes after the separation. There are so many chromatographic methods, and based on the techniques, say techniques by chromatographic bed shape, we can classify them as column and planar chromatography, in which planar is of two types, paper chromatography and thin layer chromatography, which we call as TLC. And there are displacement chromatography, techniques by physical state of mobile phase, how the based on the stationary phase or based on the moving phase. Mobile phase means the one which is moving. We can call it as gas chromatography or liquid chromatography, which are capable to move gas or liquid. Based on affinity chromatography, we have supercritical fluid chromatography, and techniques by separation mechanism, based on the mechanism how the ions or the components separate, there our ion exchange chromatography will come. So this class series is on ion exchange chromatography. My next class series will be on exclusion chromatography. Though these two comes under based on the separation mechanism how chromatography is classified. There are so many special techniques, and again, so many new techniques are getting invented for separation of or specific separation of some component. So there are so many special techniques which are listed here. And the requirement for an ion exchange resin, which resin or which what we can use as an ion exchanger or ion exchange resin. Ion exchanger, it is a device which is packed with an ion exchange resin. Therefore, here this whole setup we can call it as an ion exchanger. So it's a device which contains the ions or resins, then which we use to separate a mixture of components. Ion exchange, it is a process of purification of aqueous solution using solid polymeric ion exchange resins. So the term encompasses a large variety of processes where the ions are exchanged between two electrolytes. So here the ions are interchanged in such a way that finally we can separate the component A and component B, which is given in the schematic diagram. Which can be unselected or have binding preferences for certain ions or class of ions depending on their chemical structure. That means the resin which we use in ion exchange chromatography, or the material that we take inside the ion exchange chromatography instrument that is having a selectivity or unselectivity, either it is select or it will deselect, or it will bind some of the ions, it will not bind some of the ion. So these properties are used to separate the components present in a mixture. Okay, so it also depends upon the chemical structure of the components taken for the separation. So this can be dependent on the size of the ions, their charge or their structure also decides the speed of separation or the fastness in which we can separate or the effectiveness of separation. Typical examples of ions that can bind to an ion exchangers are proton, hydroxide, or sodium plus, K plus, Cl minus, which are singly charged monatomic, or doubly charged ions like calcium 2 plus, Mg 2 plus, or polyatomic inorganic ions like SO4 2 minus, PO4 3 minus, organic bases, organic acids, and even biomolecules like amino acids, peptides, proteins can bind to an ion exchange resin, on particular that specific ion exchange resin. A single ion exchange resin cannot be used for all. For individual applications, individual separation, individual ions, based on that we have to use the ion exchange resins. The separation or the removal of or the component separation, it is based on adsorption, absorption, as well as the sorption. The schematic representation it is given there, so it will be very clear to you. So I'm not going in detail about adsorption, absorption, and desorption concepts. So these are not the same for all components, all mixtures. Their sorption property or adsorption property or the absorption properties are not the same with a particular ion exchange polymer which we use in the ion exchange chromatographic instrument. So based on that, the separation takes place. Just like you see, component B is not moving fast, component A is moving fast. That depends upon the their ability to absorb or adsorb or sorb on a given ion exchange resin. An ion exchange resin, it is actually a reversible process, and the ion exchanger can be regenerated or loaded with desirable ions. The requirement of ion exchange resin is to effectively bind the counter ions of the sample or the mixture of sample to separate them. And that mainly depends upon the selectivity of the resin. We have to select a suitable ion exchange resin for this particular separation based on the components that we have, based on the mixtures. Component, what I mean is a mixture. From that, we want to separate them individually. We have to collect the individual components from that. Therefore, there are different resins we have to identify, and those resins' selectivity and the factors affecting that will be explained in detail in coming classes. Now this is type of ion exchange resin. An ion exchange resin or ion exchange polymer is a resin or polymer that acts as a medium for ion exchange. Okay, so this resin or the polymer what we use inside that device, that is a medium for the exchange of ions. With the exchange of ions only, the separation of a components takes place. It is an insoluble matrix. Means it will not dissolve in that. It acts as a structural support. It gives us support the that's having particular structural property, and they normally in the form of a small micro beads. Micro, that is the size what we call beads. You know what are the beads? Pearl like structure we call it as beads. Micro beads having a radius of 0.25 to 0.5 millimeter radius. Usually they are having white or yellowish in color. They are fabricated from organic polymer substrate. These beads are typically porous in nature. They are having pores, the beads which we formed. What are the beads that are everything? Coming classes will see the images and its explanation. So just keep in mind that we are using small beads, polymer beads, having porous nature. They will provide a large surface area, and inside the pores also the ions can trap, on the surface also the ion can trap, and finally the components or from the mixture the components separation will be efficient and effective. Then we call it as ion exchange chromatography. There are multiple types of ion exchange resins. But for the most commercial resins are made up of polystyrene sulfonate. The polystyrene sulfonate structure is given here. It's a polymer. Therefore, this structure, whatever given here inside the bracket, including that benzene ring with the SO3 is minus, that will get repeated n times. Okay, so it's a very long chain polymer. Millions of this particular structure will be there in polystyrene sulfonate. So there are mainly four types of ion exchange resins, which differ in their functional group. So based on the functional group, we have strongly acidic ion exchange resin, strongly basic ion exchange resin, weakly acidic ion exchange resin, and weakly basic ion exchange resin. So this given example with the sulfonic acid, so 3 minus H plus, it is a strongly acidic ion exchange resin, a polymer containing, a polymer structure containing this functional group can act as a strongly acidic ion exchange resin. If it is in sodium form, so here it is given H plus. In place of H plus, if it is Na plus or sodium form, then it can remove the hardness. Essentially, the hardness is caused by calcium and magnesium from water. If it is hydrogen form, that is this particular form only, SO3 minus H plus, then they remove all cations. They are also used as a catalyst. Examples are listed here. Even here, these are the commercially available strongly acidic ion exchange resins. The uniform particle size means all the beads, what I said in previous slide, those beads are of uniform size. And conventional means it is a mixture of different shaped beads or the porous beads. A strongly basic ion exchange resins are having the functional group of quaternary ammonium as the functional group. It's a representation given NaCl3 thrice plus OH minus. If it is in hydroxyl form only, the given form OH minus, they remove all anions. If in place of OH minus, if you treat it with sodium chloride, it becomes chloride form. So the chloride form, they remove nitrate, sulfate, and several other ions. The examples are given here with the uniform and conventional commercially available strongly basic ion exchange resins are listed out here. Weakly acidic, that means it consists of a functional group carboxylic acid, COOH, in hydrogen form, that is this particular form only, COOH, they remove preferentially divalent ions, that is calcium and magnesium, from solution containing alkalinity. So it can be used for the conversion of alkaline water to normal water. And the examples are also listed at the weakly acidic. It contains amines. A secondary amine structure is given here, NCH3 twice. Dimethylamine structure is given. After cation exchange, they remove chloride, sulfate, nitrate, and other anions of strong acid, but they do not remove weak acids like SiO2 and CO2. Examples are given. It is listed there. Specialized ion exchange resins or the chelating resins. Chelating resins are called specialized ion exchange resin. Example like amino diacetic acid and thiourea based resins. They are not classified under the other categories. They are separate category. That in separate class series, I will explain. There are mainly anion exchange resin and cation exchange resins are the most commonly used resins, in which the anion resins, they attract the negative charge ions, and cation exchange resins, they attract the positive charged ions. So some of the commercially available ion exchange resin with the solid cation exchanger, solid anion exchanger, and liquid cation as well as liquid anion exchangers are given here as an example. The synthesis of ion exchange resins in detail about general synthesis of ion exchange resins, then strongly acidic ion exchange resin, strongly basic, weakly basic, as well as strongly weakly acidic ion exchange resins, and it is polystyrene based and even polyacrylamide based resins. All the synthesis part I'll explain in next class. Hope you understood the basics of ion exchange resin introduction class number one, and have a nice day.